Lot 131 in our auction is this large oil on canvas by Richard Staunton Cahill, a genre painter, as they called him, of the 19th century. Richard Staunton Cahill was born in County Clare in 1826, and he went on to Dublin to study art at the Royal Hibernian Academy, graduating around 1850. And from then on, for the next 50 years, he exhibited regularly at the Academy, and his works were very, very popular indeed. He also exhibited at the Royal Academy in London from around the same time, and also the Royal Society of British Artists and several other galleries in London and elsewhere in England. So he was a well-established and a very popular and a very accomplished artist in both Ireland and Britain in the 19th century, and considered quite important too. And this picture will show you why he was regarded so highly. In this interesting genre scene, we see an Irish cottage or cabin, as it might have been called, a small farmhouse, possibly in the Clare Galway area, but as we'll come to see later, it may well be from one of the northern counties. We have here a man reading a newspaper to the group. We have the man of the house, the woman of the house, Ballantee. We have an older gentleman seated here and a young boy. Now, this habit of reading the newspaper was common at the period. This is around 1870. And probably if we looked at this, if we saw the same group 50 years later, they'll all be grouped around a radio when Radio Éireann started in 1926, or later on, 50 years later, when television came about, they could be all grouped around a television set watching the news or the sport or whatever. And of course, if we move it on to our own time, they would probably all be using their mobile phones to look up the news and the gossip. So what we're looking at here, in effect, as Michael Parsons, the Irish Times, said, an example of social media in 1871, and is a good way of describing the scene. The reader here is probably in the traditional style of the old Shanachie, the storyteller. So it's actually evolving from that, where the storytellers used to go from house to house, carrying the folk tales of Ireland from place to place. Here, the newspaper's taken over the old traditional stories. And what's very interesting historically about this is that this is the post-famine period in Irish history. And at that time, the newspaper industry in Ireland had grown tremendously, from having maybe about 50 titles at the beginning of the century. By the end of the century, had maybe 150 titles. And a lot of the new newspapers were not spouting the establishment ideas on life and the way the country was run. Rather, they were nationalist papers. Papers like The Nation and The Freeman's Journal were espousing the causes of nationalism, the land reform, later the Land League and so forth. So what we're looking at here is maybe the beginning of the dissemination of knowledge to the greater populace about our independence. And this would lead in turn to the independence movement of the late 19th century and of course on to the 1916 Rising and so forth. So an important, what I would say, seeds of independence. Looking at the picture here, we see, as I said, the gentleman reading the paper here, a great detail in the paper. You can see his coat is a little bit ripped, so he's not the richest man in the neighbourhood, though obviously he had the money to pay for the paper, twopence or threepence or whatever it was. And we have here the woman of the house. She's got her head is covered. That indicated her marital status, that she was married. She is probably married to this gentleman here with the hat. She's sitting on what's called a stake-legged stool, according to Claudia Kinmonth. Dr. Claudia Kinmonth wrote an excellent note, by the way, for the catalogue, well worth looking at. It's online as well. And Claudia points out that this treadle spinning wheel is of a type that was normally at that time in the northern counties to do with the flax industry. So maybe this isn't a West of Ireland picture. It might be more towards the north of the country. And there's great detail here. We can see the plate displayed proudly, and the little rushlight. Those are quite a collectible item these days. We have the men seated near the half door. The half door is an important part of the house in those days, because the half door, by having a half door, you could let in the light, and yet you kept animals out and you kept the kiddies indoors. So quite a useful device. There's other little things, a slate written hanging up here, and an unusual inscription up here on the top left. And we haven't quite worked out what that is. There is a 50 mark there. Some people suggested it's something to do with 1850, which was the Reform Act, which gave wider rights to vote in the country, which again would have led on to the political status later on. It's signed down here by the artist and dated 1871. It's a very fine picture of museum quality, good condition, nicely framed too, and it's estimated at 8,000 to 10,000 euro, which I think is very modest for a picture that's not only aesthetically pleasing, that's well painted, in good condition, but also has some significant historical importance. So a fine painting, I certainly wouldn't mind owning it.